Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, and today's video is my December favorites. This month has been kind of hectic due to me trying to finish finals and trying to make sure my first semester of my sophomore year was on a good note, a decent note, and the two amazing holidays of Christmas and New Year's, and I have a part-time job, so it's been like super crazy. But throughout this entire month, I have collected some really, really cute goodies that I am so happy to show you. So without further ado, let's get started with the video. My first category in my December favorites is beauty. I am really, really into beauty and skincare and makeup at the moment. I feel like it's slowly getting larger and larger, my addiction to wanna buy a bunch of makeup products. So this month I've collected a couple goodies that I just like love so much. So the first one is the Makeup Geek Contour Pan in Warm Deep. This product is awesome. Like, as a woman of color, it's really hard to find makeup companies and brands that actually work well with your skin tone without making you look too dark or too light, and it's just not working for you. So this product, for me specifically, just works so well. I use it as my contour, like obviously it says contour pan, contour on my cheeks, my under my chin, and my forehead, so I can like really be defined and my face can be like really, really nice shaped. And this product is really awesome. I also bought, when I bought this, I bought the Blush Chivalry, and I really, really enjoy it. Like, the way it applies, the consistency of it. I wish I had a container to put it in instead of having it in the package, but I don't have that right now, so I just have to do with what I have to do with. This is really awesome. Like, I really enjoyed their products, and everything is pigmented. Like, it works well with my skin tone, and like, when a product or a brand can do that, like, I will stay with them for life. So yeah, I'm kind of addicted. My next beauty favorite is my MAC lip pencil in Chestnut. I love to wear like nude lips, nude matte lips a lot, and this lip pencil really saves the day for me. Like, it outlines my lips really nicely where I get my full, like, the effect of my lips and their shape, and it's really, really pretty on me. And I like to wear it with this lip combo of NYX London. Combine these two together and like, these are a match made in heaven. Like, this makes your lips look so like natural. If you're a woman of color and you try this, it doesn't matter what like shade you are, but if you're a woman of color and you need a nice nude combo, this is the one for you. Like, you can do a bunch of NYX's like lighter shades, like Cannes, Stockholm, and London. You can combine these two together and like your lips look natural, and it's really, really pretty. I love it. I'm actually wearing it right now with like a combination of Dubai as like my lipstick, I guess, and my lip liner, MAC, obviously. And I really enjoy it. Like, it's such a cute lip. Like, if you can tell, like, I just love this lip combination so much. My next beauty favorite has to be the Makeup Forever Professionals Glossy Full Lip Gloss. This right here is awesome. Like, I was rushing one day to go to school, and I was like, I need some lip gloss. Like, I don't know what's going on. My lips are chapped, I need some lip gloss before I go to class. And I asked my mom, I was like, Mom, do you have any lip gloss? And she hands me this, and I have not given it back because it's just that good. Like, I had to keep it for myself. This is really, really awesome. Like, this keeps my lips super, super moisturized, and I love the like look of really glossy lips, like kind of overly glossed lips. Like, I just think it looks super cute, and this product actually gives me that effect, and I love it so much, and I wear it every time I like wash my face, brush my teeth type of deal, night and day, but mostly at night, because when I wake up, my lips are super plump and full and really moisturized. My second category and my December favorites is skincare. I love skincare. I'm addicted to skincare. Like, I'm so into self-care this year, and skincare has always been something I've been fascinated with. I think that if your skin isn't like healthy and well kept, that your makeup isn't gonna be applied properly. Like, it's not gonna lay right, it's not gonna look good when it's over, because the foundation, like your skin, is not right. So how can your makeup be right? So that being said, my first skincare favorite would have to be my Vanity Planet Spin for Perfect Skin brush. This brush is a dual purpose brush, so it's like they have four spin heads to it. This is the body spin head. I love this. Like, I've been using it a lot lately because at first I was like, I don't know, like I already have like a loofah, like I don't need anything else to like scrub my skin with. But boy, was I wrong. Like, this thing is awesome. Like, it's so nice and soothing towards my skin. I noticed that my skin is a lot smoother after I get out of shower and touch my skin, like lotion down and stuff. It is a lot smoother. There are, I think, three other heads that go with this product. And my favorite one, like as I take it off, my favorite one is the Everyday, I guess, washing of your face, like the Everyday brush. I love this. I love like using the two brushes. Like after I take a shower, I use this. And I think this is awesome. Like, this is a like 4-in-1 type of deal. And like, I'm so happy. And I'm like, this, I got this on Skate. I got this on their sale. And it was really, really nice. It was $30. Usually I think it's $100. So you always need to catch Vanity Planet when they have a sale. I got this on the holiday sale and this thing is awesome. Like, it makes my skin feel so like nice and soft, and I really, really enjoy it. Like, at first it's kind of aggressive when like I turn it on and I apply it to my face. It's like kind of like, because it only has one setting, with the Ultimate Skin Spa system, it has two settings. With this one, it's only one setting. So like, as soon as you put it on your face, it does feel kind of harsh. But after a while, I'm like massaging it on my face and I really, really enjoy it. Like, this is about to be a fave for a long time. My second skincare favorite would have to be my Philosophy Purity Made Simple Cleanser. And I think this is, yeah, this is the one-step facial cleanser. This thing is awesome. Like, Philosophy is amazing. Like, I have never like used a product that was so simple besides, I forgot, I think it's like Soy Face Cleanser. That was very simple. I really, really like that product. But Purity Made Simple by Philosophy is like amazing. I have been using this cleanser since July. And I've always had the travel size ones, but for Christmas I got this, and this thing is so big. Like, I think I have at least 3 months if I don't like go crazy and use it like in 1 month. I don't think I will, but in case I do, I have to go buy some more. But this is amazing. Like, the formula is so simple. Like, it's easy to follow. Like, the directions on the back are easy to follow. The ingredients, aqua, water, things that you need to hydrate your skin, really simple. Like, the simple the product, the better. Like, if I can't pronounce anything that's on the ingredients, I shouldn't be using it, because you don't want it to dry your skin. And I feel like a lot of products have that drying capacity, and you really, really have to look out for that type of stuff. This is awesome. Like, I use this cleanser every morning and every night. I wash my face. This thing is awesome, and I recommend it for literally anyone. And I don't think it like matters what kind of skin you have. I think it helps soothe all problems for like acneic skin, combination skin, oily skin, all that type of good stuff. So I love it so much. It's so nice. Like, my third category and my December favorites is clothing. So I love clothes. I love shopping. I think I have a problem. Like, I feel like all girls have that problem. But this month, I have been rocking this pretty, pretty awesome bomber, like, nonstop. Like, I think anytime that I go out or I go to lunch or whatever, I'm wearing this baby here. This jacket, let's just, like, enjoy it for a moment. Let's just look at it and be like, wow, that's a beauty. It is so cute. And, like, on the back, it has the Highlands on it. And a cool story about this is that I live in a neighborhood called Virginia Highlands, and the fact that it has the Highlands on the back, I feel like I'm a great representation of my neighborhood, and I'm repping Highlands, so it's all good. The reason why I like this jacket so much is because of the rose details on them, the embroidered roses, as you can see right here. It's really pretty. Like, the color combination is so appealing to the eye, like the cream with the black, then the, like, I guess the dark navy with the black and the green and the red. All of it looks really, really beautiful. And this is, I got this from Forever 21 Plus, but I feel like a person that is it plus size could rock this jacket. I bought this when I was in a desperate need for a silk bomber from Urban Outfitters and I think Zara or Topshop. And like theirs are super duper expensive for like no reason. Like I don't understand why, because this jacket looks exactly like something you would buy at Urban Outfitters or Zara or Topshop. So I'm like kind of confused on why theirs are so expensive, but this was not. This, I don't really remember the price. Like now that I'm talking about all of these prices, whatever. This was not that expensive. I think that's why I purchased it. And I was going on a splurge. I really shouldn't have been shopping that day. But whatever, I have got this jacket and I wear this all the time. Like I can't put it down. It's so nice and it's really cute. Like it is a staple, like I guess spring, summer, fall. You can wear it whenever and it's really, really nice. My second fashion favorite this month. This has been one of my favorites for like all the months, honestly, like since I bought this. I think I bought this in like October, I think. My jean culottes from Zara. These pants are like amazing. You can't really see me, sorry. These pants are awesome. Like I love them so much. I was scared that I could not fit these because of the fact that they only had large and I was trying to get extra large just to be safe because I am bottom heavy. I wanted to have these culottes because I love the way they look. Like I think that it's very flattering to my hips and also really awesome how they have that masculine feature with the wide leg, like the wide pant leg. Like I think that's so nice and so cool. And I love how frayed the bottoms are. I think that's so like chic, kind of like high fashion, I don't know. I think they look really cute and I love like the different dyed, like this is darker than that denim. I think that's really, really pretty. These are the back, so you can see the back. These pants are just everything to me. Like I love culottes. Like I only have two pairs, both from Zara, by the way. And I really, 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 really enjoy wearing these pants. They are really tight in the hip area. I do get a little uncomfortable because of how tight they are. But after a couple of minutes, they kind of diffuse, like my body gets adjusted to them. Especially since I've washed them. Like when I first got them, I didn't wash them frequently because I was afraid they were gonna shrink and like I couldn't fit them anymore. But after I washed them, my body kind of formed to the material better and it fits really, really well. Like I adore these pants. My next, like this is in the category of clothing, would be shoes. And these are my favorite shoes. My Vans slip-ons or slide-ons, I think that's how they say them. These babies are awesome. Like these are a great everyday shoe. I wear these to work all the time. I just started doing that. I don't know why. They're just so cool. Like I just feel so like in the know with these shoes. You know what I'm saying? Like, hello, I'm in the know. Oh, that was so lame. I'm really sorry. That was so lame. I'm sorry about that, whatever. I love Vans. I have so many of them. Like, I collect Vans, like, as a side, like, a hobby. Like, besides blogging and YouTube, I collect Vans. Because Vans are really awesome. And they're really, like, they're cheap. They're a cheap pair of shoes. And what's really cool about Vans' website, if you guys don't know, it's, like, when you buy a shoe or you buy a pair of shoes, you can see, like, the good and the bad in what you're buying. And I think that's awesome. Like, not a lot of websites do that. Where you can, like, they actually are honest. So, like, these shoes aren't comfortable. They are not. I'm not gonna be honest. These shoes are not comfortable. But like if I have a good pair of socks on and I'm like not, I really don't care, like my feet aren't hurting that bad, I'll wear them all day long. Like I work like probably, I would say 7 to 8 hour shifts and I wear them through that duration and it's not that bad. And I love how like they can look kind of dirty a little bit. Like I love kind of like in between clean and dirty shoes. Like I just think that's so like retro, so cute. Anyway, I adore these shoes. If you don't have any, you should definitely get some because they are awesome. And black is always a great color. Like, you can never go wrong with black because black don't crack. Okay, that was another lame joke. I am so sorry. Like, My fourth category in my December favorites would be accessories. I am the type of girl that doesn't really focus on accessories as much as I should. Like, I like to focus on the things that matter that I think people are gonna be looking at more, which is like tops, bottoms, shoes, and a jacket, and maybe a cap. But like earrings and necklaces and rings and watches and all that junk, I am just not interested in those things. But for the month of December, I was like, I need to start. Like, I don't know what it is, I just need to get on it. So this month, I have two favorites in accessories. So let me grab them really quick. My first favorite would be the classic aviator glasses. Like, these things are so freaking cute. I'm gonna put them on right now. Let's see if I can put them on. These things are so cute. They like change who I am. I don't know how they do that. Like, I just feel like, what is up? What's good? Like, don't I look good right now, you know? Like, this is cute. Like, I feel so cute with these glasses on. And everyone is where I am. Like, this is the trend to look like a 80s science teacher. You know what I'm saying? Like, look like a dad or somebody telling somebody what to do. Like, somebody bald-headed wore these glasses. You know what I'm saying? I love these glasses so much. I got them from Amazon, and they were like 16 something. I don't know. I don't know, really remember the price. I'm lying. I'm so sorry. I don't remember the price at all. But I really, really, really like these. I tend to wear these when I'm having a bum day and like I'm doing errands or something. Like over Christmas break, I wore these. Ooh, girl, my lights almost just fell. Ooh, okay. Over Christmas break, I was sending off packages to friends, and I wore these to the post office, and I felt so like cool, like, you know, like, ooh, I wish somebody would tell me something about myself, you know, because I look good, you know. I really love wearing them like when I'm relaxed and like running errands. I just think these are so cute, like so retro, and I think that's my style, is like a retro chic. My second accessory favorites would have to be my bamboo styled metal earrings. These, I also got these from Amazon. These are so cute. Like, I wish they were bigger. Like, I swore when I ordered them, they were gonna be a lot bigger than what they are right now. They're kind of like a medium small size, and they are really cute. They do hurt my ears though when I am, like when I put them in, the clasp like somehow like gets stuck on my ear, and it's really irritating. But overall, these are really cute earrings. Like, I would go get, I'm gonna buy some more anyway because I want them to be a lot bigger. Like, I want like real big ass hoops, you know what I'm saying? Like, I wanna look super cute in these. And I feel like the combination with these glasses and these earrings are just like, dang, like she got style, you know what I'm saying? Like, I really, really love the combo. I wanna try and show you guys, like, if you can imagine me being a fierce woman wearing these two combos. My fifth and final category would be music. I love music. I feel like everybody loves music. I feel like I'm like trying to be all different or whatever, but music is awesome. Music saves lives. Music is just everything to me. And for the month of December, I like listen to all of my favorites, all the things that get me through. That's what I listen to, because I was going through stress with finals. I was trying to work literally every day. I had to go buy presents for people, and like, when I'm going through town, I need to be in the car jamming out. Like, I need to be rocking out hard. Like, I need to get through. I need to make sure I get to the store, and I need to be at peace, and I need to just really have some good tunes in my car. So, my first music favorite would have to be Childish Gambino, Redbone, and Mia Your Mama. Okay, my love for Childish Gambino is real. Like, it is a real thing. Like, I just love him so much. He is such a talented artist. I've been with him since camp. I've been with him since Stone Mountain EP. I have been with him. Every step of the way, I have been there for Childish. Like, I really, really, really love him. Like, I think he is so intelligent and smart when it comes to articulating emotion or a time period that I deeply relate to, because he's from Atlanta, I'm from Atlanta, and for him to capture a moment in my childhood and not even know me is like groundbreaking to me in my head. Like, I'm like, dang, how did he, you know what I'm saying? Like, how did, can he feel what I felt at the same time? But we were like, we don't know each other. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think he's just a powerful person. And his new album, Awaken My Love, is a masterpiece. When I tell you, I listen to that all the time. It's something that is different sound. It's not like rapping like he's used to like doing in previous albums, but I feel like the more albums he releases, the more he comes into himself, and I really, really appreciate it. Like these two songs, Redbone, I think that's like one of the like featured songs, like a hit, like a I don't know the word for it, but like, you know, the songs that play on the radio, that's one. And then Me and Your Mama, it's just like good music. It's just, I don't know, it just really feeds my soul. So yeah, that's that one. My second favorite music song, whatever, this for the month of December is Frank Ocean's Night and Self Control. Okay, Frank Ocean, this is such a gassed up topic, but I'm just gonna keep it simple and say that I appreciate him dropping Blonde and then leaving us. Like I it's fine, like I'm not really that deep, it's not that deep to me, but I appreciate these two songs because Nights, there's something about it being two songs and it making you feel two different ways that I'm like, whoa, you know, like I really, really appreciate it. Then Self Control, there's like some point where his voice changes and it sounds like a completely different person, and it literally hits me every single time. Like I feel like my soul has connected with the person's voice and we are having a moment. I'm getting really too deep into this music right now, but I love music, so I have to tell it like it is. These two songs are just really awesome, pivotal, like every time I listen to this album, I have to play those two songs over again. And it's just awesome. Also, a bonus for the album that I really like, a bonus song that I like is the one with Andre 3000, which is Solo Part 2, I think. Andre 3000, OG, for real, for real. Like, he is OG. And like, that one like rap verse, I mean, not rap verse, but the whole song, it's short, sweet, and to the point, and it like really encapsulates what he's thinking and where he's at, and it's really awesome. Like I thought it was a really nice cherry on top type of thing to the song. My next favorite song is Kalyon Fox, Eof, I don't know how to pronounce it. I'll leave it down in the description. Radio Number 5 on SoundCloud. Okay, Kalyon Fox, if you guys don't know about him, he is a YouTuber and like he makes skits. He's really, really funny and super talented, so like you should definitely subscribe to him. He has radio stations, or like he just made this thing called You Are Now Living Healthy. That's something completely different from what I'm talking about. He has like these radios, like I think 1 through 6 or 7, I'm not really sure, but Number 5 Radio is awesome. Like I don't know, every song is a music capsule where it's like a bunch of artists and a bunch of songs, and he's made like a radio station about it, and I really, really enjoy it. Like I listen to it all the time. It's one of those things that like I'll go back to, like I remember, like, oh, I need to listen to this, like when I'm really in need of like soul music, or like I don't know, anything, like I just want to like a pick me up, I listen to his radio stations because they're like really good R&B songs that I like listening to. I'm like, some of the artists I've never even heard of, and I've like found new music because of this radio station. All right, everyone, that is all of my December favorites. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. I have also made a blog post on my website, inbetweenlooks.com, about my December favorites. And if you are a literal person and you like words, you should definitely check that out. And thank you so much for watching this video. You could please like, if you want to, this is not like a serious thing. If you want to, you can like, comment, and subscribe to this channel because the support means a lot to me. Like, I am not getting paid. Like, I'm not the type of YouTuber yet. And just to know that I am doing a good job, or like you need to work on something, really means a lot to me. We should also be friends. We should like follow each other on social media. I will definitely link everything. All of the favorites will definitely be linked in the description bar below. We should be friends and follow each other on social media. I will link my Snapchat, my Instagram, my Pinterest, And yeah, I do not have a Tumblr. I've taken a break from Tumblr. Tumblr can be a really crazy place if you let it, so I'm gonna just take a break from that. I don't know, maybe in the summer I'll start it up again. But I'm rambling. Let me exit this video immediately. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next one. Bye.